Awuchela abantu bonke, tshela umhlaba wonke.
Tshela abantu bonke, tshela umhlaba wonke. Tshela abantu bonke, tshela umhlaba wonke. Tshela abantu bonke.
Now this is just coming up and we're going to go over and have some breakfast, and then we're going to head out to the Ngorongoro crater, which is no more than a mile or two up the road from where we're staying right now. And after a day of safari in the crater, we will return here for another evening, and then we'll start our way back to the little city of Arusha, where we will be able to get a plane back to Nairobi and back to the States. A lot of the labor at the monastery is performed by the ladies that stay here. They work up in the fields, they gather firewood, and in the garden. Most of the fruits and vegetables are grown locally right here on the monastery grounds. Not only do they have great fruits and vegetables, they also grow an assortment of different types of flowers. All the fresh milk is provided right here by their own little dairy. And after a great breakfast, we are on our way to the Ngorongoro Conservation Area, where we will visit Ngorongoro Crater. The gate is located about a half a mile ahead.
This vast country, brimming with natural wonder, is the very heart of nature itself. With its stunning beauty, its kaleidoscope of landscapes, and its veritable cornucopia of animal and plant life, Tanzania is a country where, for most of its inhabitants, the pace of existence follows the natural rhythm of life and death, of evolution, migration, and the changing seasons.
Well, we made it to the Ngorongoro Conservation Area. So now what I need to do is to go inside and get us some tickets and get us on our way. The great majority of the tourists that come to the conservation area usually come by busload or separate safari vehicles. We chose to rent our own vehicle to avoid the hassles of being with tour companies. It's a little more complicated to buy tickets for individual private vehicles like we are. Say hi, Phyllis.
Hi.
Looking into Ngorongoro Crater. The Ngorongoro Conservation Area is a conservation area and a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and it's located 180 kilometers west of Arusha in the Crater Highlands area of Tanzania. The crater is a large volcanic caldera. It is recognized by one private organization as one of the 7th wonders of the world. The main feature of the conservation area is the crater. It's the world's largest inactive, intact, and unfilled volcanic caldera. The crater, which formed when a large volcano exploded and collapsed on itself 2 to 3 million years ago, it is 2,000 feet deep, and the floor covers 260 square kilometers, or 100 square miles. Well, we're about halfway into the crater at this point and decided to stop and take a short lunch break. We no sooner got to the crater floor when we started noticing all kinds of animals around us. There were all kinds of zebras and wildebeest, and as we went along, we encountered this large bull elephant off the side of the road. We tried to get a little closer to this cheetah, but he wouldn't have anything to do with us. Please do not get out of your vehicle at this time. We usually run into other vehicles along the way, and we were stopped here, and we noticed these lions just having a ball around us. Later on in the afternoon, I decided to let Phyllis take the wheel and let her drive through the crater where she wanted to go, and she did a pretty good job maneuvering around all the obstacles that were there on the crater floor. Of course, there were some areas that I was rather impressed that she decided to take, like this small stream, which was no problem at all. It's actually recording right now. If you could just focus the two of us in.
Oh my God, it's such an honor. Oh, we love you.
And Ngorongoron Crater, Africa. Look who we run into, the one and only. It's Aaron Neville.
Howdy, howdy.
This
All
is
right.
an honor.
We're having a great time, yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Love to see you here.
Thank you. Thank you. Nice meeting you.
Yes, sir. You too.
Thank you.
And you too, young lady. And if you stay stopped long enough, you're going to find some animals that will come up to you and offer curious to see what you're up to. Like this band of monkeys that kind of invaded the vehicle until we had to start the vehicle up and drive on with them on the hood for a while. This is the quarry busted. It usually remains on the ground because they are really heavy birds. The male quarry bustard may be the heaviest living animal capable of flight. And warthogs you can find at any turn of the road. As we were traveling through the crater, we noticed this large herd of wildebeest heading toward our way, so we stopped and sat there for a while and found ourselves in the middle of the herd. Well, we've seemed to have gotten ourselves right in the middle of the path of the migration. There's one right behind us here. This one's taking a pee.
Oh, you just missed that one.
You just warned? Heard it. The largest lake within the crater is Lake Magadi, or Makat, as the Maasai call it, with the meaning of salt. Due to the disposition of volcanic ash, the lake became very alkaline, but that didn't bother the flamingos from inhabiting it. There's more to see than can ever be seen. Of course, the brine water isn't very good for the animals, so they basically stay away from it. This is the hoopie. It is a beautiful bird, commonly feeds on the ground, and usually seen in small, noisy flocks. There are also a lot of zebras in the area. In Now, I was not aware that they had alligators in Africa. I met some ostrich along the way also, which was a very strange looking bird. And occasionally we'd be stopped by guards to check our passports, make sure we're in the country legally. Now this animal is vulnerable to all the other predators on it because it was actually giving birth. And once on the crater floor, it was easy to get turned around with all these roads with no markings whatsoever in any direction that you're going in. And this is the black-back jackal, a hardy species and well adapted to the crater. Also seemed to keep running into a lot of ostrich that were in the crater, as these two in their mating dances. We stayed there for a while and observed the mating dance and casually went on our way. Now we run into the Cape buffalo. Pretty mean animal. You don't want to get out of the vehicle at this time. And I see he has an ox picker on him, which is a common bird in Africa, which walks on the backs of these animals, picking off fleas and ticks or any other insects. I was trying to get them a little closer to the vehicle. I guess you're not supposed to drive off the beaten trails down in the crater. Well, it's later on in the afternoon now, and we decided to make our way back to the crater rim. But we noticed this large bull elephant that was walking in front of us, so we decided to stop a while and observe him. I'm sure these people had some memorable video and photos that they brought home with them. A little while later, he left the road and he started making our way back to where we were located. At this point, I think he recognized that we were stopped there on the side of the road. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become. It looked to be a rather old male. Well, it's about time we leave the crater and make our way back to Arusha, where we get on a plane and fly back to Nairobi the following morning. And a few hours later, we'll make our way back to the United States with a short stopover in London. And I want to thank all of you for taking the time for watching this video. Thank you very much.